Now, for the fun part. Once the rain garden shape and soil mix has been established, the next step is planting your plants. Options include small trees, shrubs, perennials, and grasses. The term rain garden is really a misnomer, as more often than not, this area will be dry, not wet. Therefore, selecting hardy species with a range of drought and wet condition tolerance is essential. Consider your native plant species. If you have experienced a South Carolina summer, you know. We'll have a weekend where we might receive 6 inches of rain, and then it might not rain again for 2 or 3 weeks. Our native plant species have adapted to these conditions, and therefore, many South Carolina native plants perform well in a South Carolina rain garden. You may even select plants that attract wildlife, such as butterflies and other pollinators, hummingbirds and other bird species, and more. As there are many plant species to choose from, Clemson Extension has developed just the tools to help you make your choices. Visit the Clemson Extension Carolina Yards plant database at clemson.edu/cy/plants. This is a searchable plant database that allows you to select plants that are rain garden specific. This website is definitely worth visiting when you are in the plant selection phase of your rain garden. Also, download a free copy of the Clemson Carolina Clear Rain Garden Manual, which includes an extensive list of recommended plants for rain gardens. This guide can be downloaded at clemson.edu/CarolinaClear. And lastly, visit the SC Waterways Fact Sheet Series to gain more detailed information on selecting plants appropriate for rain gardens. And don't forget, the best times to plant are spring and fall, when our temperature ranges are typically less stressful on newly established plants.